Actually, solid would be a liquid lipstick. Lip lipstick. Wow. Oh no, don't dig the palette in the shade, really. Hello, my lovely nestlings, and welcome to today's video where I'm going to play and review for you guys the newest collection from Unique Beauty, which is this one, the Festive Collection. I have all three palettes here. She also sent me some extra goodies. I am going to go over everything. And if you're new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 45 from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And if you want to learn how to be fabulous in your 40s, if you want to hear about brands that no one else is talking about, if you want to be inspired by unusual color combinations, then this is the channel for you. Subscribe now, become part of my nestlings, because we are having a blast here on the internet with our Halloween event that will be transformed in a few days' time to the Nightmare Before Christmas band. And I'm already ready, because I'm very much having Sally vibes today. Yes, she sent me the collection, all three palettes that I have here. Yes, she also sent me two lippies that I'm going to try out in today's video. And she sent me one of her loose shadows as well in the shade Grimoire. And I am using everything. And at the end of the video, I give you my thoughts on everything. How is this video set up though? It is set up per palette. Why? Because you can buy all the palettes separately. So I am reviewing all the palettes separately, and then at the end of the video I can give you my overall thoughts on the entire collection, if I think that the palettes work together, what I feel about the lippies, and all that goodness. Yes, that is it. This collection was sent to me in PR. Did I already say that? I think I did, right? Yeah. I also have an affiliate code with her in case you want to shop. However, I think that she's having a 50% off sale right now until the 31st. So now is the time to grab stuff. I will link her site down below. Before we go any further, grab a drink and a snack and put your feet up and enjoy, because here comes palette number one, the Warm Autumn. The first palette, the Warm Autumn. Six shades, as all her palettes have, three mattes and three shimmers. And the shimmers have different finishes, and there's not really a traditional shimmer inside, honestly, because they all have something, something extra. I did notice though that the mattes felt a little bit dry when I swatched them. Not that there's anything wrong with that. It usually kind of means for me that they will crease less. So let's see how they will behave. I'm going to start with a shade called Chai Latte. I'm kind of going to build a little bit of definition in the crease. I'm just going to tap it on. Okay, I'm with the same brush, I'm going to go into the shade called Pumpkin Spice. And this one has more vibrancy. Just going to place it on top. Start in the outer corner and then work my way in. With a smaller brush, if I can find it, yes. I'm going to go to the shade Thanksgiving, which is kind of a, I don't know, is it a dark berry? I never know. It's a reddish brown. And this is a bit on the drier side. So let's see what it will do. I'm also kind of fading it out on top of my lashes. Now I'm going to go back to the previous brush, blend the two shades together. A little bit of pumpkin spice, that orange. I want to try them all, so I'm going to go to the shade Maple first. And that one has kind of a green shift in it as well. It's so pretty. I am going to spray it to help against any fallout. Not that her shimmers need it for the shine, but again, for the fallout. Oh, that's pretty. The green that is in this shade tends to fade away a little bit against my skin, even though I'm wearing a base that is a little bit more peachy because I'm a light olive. I can tell that some shades want to kind of be eaten up by me, apparently. Alright, let's go to the next shade, which is going to be S'mores. Okay, I'm going to try this dry first. Oh! Oh my lordy lord. I did not see that coming. I'm kind of going to do the same underneath my eye. So the shade Maple first and then the shade S'mores. I'm just going to spray the shade. So Maple a little bit more towards my outer corner. I'm cleaning this brush and then I'm kind of going to wiggle, wiggle, wiggle. Same here. Just going to make sure that the fading is nice. Okay, I'm going to go back to the shade Thanksgiving, which was that redder shade. It feels a little bit harder pressed in the pan. Nothing wrong with that. I just prefer a shade that has a little bit of kick up because I don't know, I find it satisfying. Inner corner. I always wanted to say I'm going to finish it off, but I have the inner corner shade called Campfire left, which has a green, I don't know if you can see it, but it has a green shift. So let's see. Ooh, let's see. And that will combine very, very well with the shade Maple as well. Because that basically that greeniness is in the shade Maple too. I'm making a mess, but that's also okay. Oh, it's so pretty. I'm going to finish it off, liner, lashes and a lippy. Then I will be back to show you the completed look and give you my opinion on this palette. I finished off the look. Favorite falsies from Babydoll in the style 723. Lippy is also from a Unique Beauty. It is the shade Ruby, but I actually thought it would be a liquid lipstick. Lipstick. Well, it's not though, it's a gloss. I did pair it with a lip liner from Catrice in the shade Polite Rebellion. It's very comfortable. I don't feel like it's bleeding. So it's very nice and it has a nice sparkle. I like it a lot. And then I paired it with my favorite sweater. I'm all in tune and ready to go grocery shopping in just a minute. But first I'm going to tell you my thoughts on this palette. I think I captured the vibe, didn't I? I think that it's a very, very autumny look. And yeah, the mattes performed like a dream, as they usually do. These are pigmented, but still buildable. So, and that means that even for me, it's not very scary to use her eyeshadows, if that makes any sense at all. So I know that some people would especially use this palette and would be like, I wish it was a little bit more pigmented, but I like the fact that it is a very buildable formula. The only thing that I noticed, and that's maybe it's also the brush that I used, is that the shade Thanksgiving is a little bit harder pressed, and I feel, and I have said that with Manny's formula from the Lunar Beauty Moonspell also, I like a little bit of kick up in the pan. I just feel it satisfying. I feel like I get more pavement. That's not always the case, but that's just a preference thing. I like me a little bit of kick up. What can I say? They layer beautifully, they blend up beautifully. I have no skipping whatsoever. Let's go to the stars of the show, which are the shimmers. Yeah, they're stunning. They are truly, truly stunning. The shade Maple is basically a chai latte, but then with a green shift in it as well. And as I said, on me, that green shift kind of fades away a little bit. It makes my eyelid look a little bit wet. And it's stunning. If you combine it with the shade Campfire, you can really bring out that green. And even on me, usually shades like that tend to turn more yellow than green, but I can still see that hint of green in the inner corner. And shade S'mores, yeah, I feel like a fiery maple leaf. That's how I feel today. So Yeah, that's it. I was kind of thinking when I was working with this palette, I was kind of thinking, would I like to have had the shade Chai Latte be deeper? On the one hand, I say yes. On the other hand, I kind of like it this way. It could have been maybe a hint deeper, but overall, yeah, I think that it is very pretty. I think that the colors or the look that I got out of it, it's nice and vibrant, but still wearable. For me, it's dark enough. And let me know your thoughts. Yeah, I think that was it. I really, really like this palette. And again, I think that she captured the outside of the palette, the artwork, very, very well with all the shades that are inside as well. This was the warm autumn palette. Yes, we are going to go to the next one, which is going to be the Dark Souls. The second palette called Dark Souls. I love the aesthetic of this a lot. This is so, so up my alley. But yeah, again, 6 shades, 3 mattes and 3 shimmers, or basically 3 mattes, 2 regular shimmers, and then a duochrome shiny goodness. And yeah, that's it. And I'm going to smear them on my eyeballs. I have already primed my eyes. And let's go from light to dark, because I want to use all the shades. So I'm going to start with the shade called Wendigo, which is a matte white. Just have to make sure that my brush is clean. Maybe I should have washed them. I'm just going to tap this in the inner corner. Now my base is still sticky. And if you really want a shade like this to show up, use a base that is light. If you can get away with it. And just tap it on a sticky base. But still, for me, I see that it shows up, which is very good. Next shade I'm going to go to is the shade called Ghoul. I can still use the same brush, because why not? I'm just tapping this on next to it. And then I'm going to gently blend the transition here. Blend the blue a little bit down and then that white a little bit up. Just to make sure that they blend nicely. I'm actually going to pull that white slightly above that. I don't even know what kind of shade that is. Bluey, purpley, ghoulish. And then I'm going to go back to the shade Ghoul. And just make sure that it is the way that I want it. Okay, and then I'm going to go to the next shade called The Entity. It's not really difficult where I'm going to place this now, is it? So I'm going to go from my bottom lid up and then in. Back to the shade Ghoul with a fluffier brush. And Wendigo, which was the matte white. Okay, I think it's time for the shimmers. Let's do a steel gray bottom. Let's start there. Okay. So I'm going to go to the shade called Grim Reaper. Bottom lid. A little bit in the outer corner. Then I'm going to go to the purple, which is called Necromancer. Oh, that's pretty. I'm kind of going to concentrate this a little bit more on the... It's very sparkly. Let's spray it, because I want to see what it does when I spray it. I kind of like it more when it's not sprayed. I feel like the, I don't know, almost the sparkles come out better then. Which is kind of weird. It's a bit of a drier formula, which I tend to prefer because that means that it creases less for me at least. Okay, and then a little bit of that steel gray just in the outer corner, the shade Grim Reaper. Oh, and I love a shade like this so much. And just wiggle a little back and forth. Wiggle, wiggle, wiggle. You know that shade Grim Reaper, that steel gray shimmer, it's kind of like the color of our sea when it's storming, which is gorgeous. Okay, now I'm going to go to the star of the show, and that's called the shade Dullahan, this one. And in my inner corner, it's going to be just on my lid, so on its own. And then after that, it's going to go on top of one of the bases, basically the colors, so that we can play a little bit with the swift. Let's start with a smaller brush. It's a flaky shade though, so let's see if I need to spray it. I'm going to tap off my brush. Let's see what it does dry on top of a white base. Very, very nice and sparkly. Oh yeah, yes, okay. I want to spray this. And the reason I want to spray this is because it makes the flakes a little bit softer. And they adhere a little bit better to the eye. Look at that. Okay, and then I'm going to, my brush is still a tiny bit damp, and with flakes I usually don't mind that too much. But I'm just going to brush that over the purple. Kind of mix them together a bit. And also a little bit on in the back on Grim Reaper. Oh wow. So yeah, again, I don't. When it's a flake, I usually don't mind it going in with a brush that is a bit sprayed. Because in a flake, you will not get hard pan, basically, if that makes any sense at all. Oh, it's like liquid metal on your eyeballs. Okay, now I also have this shade, which is the shade Grimoire. I don't know. Let's put that there, so that I have used it, because I'm really, really curious to see how it is. Oh, that's also a sparkly one. Okay, can I grab my sponge tip? Sure I can. Let's put that for funsies on the bottom lid. I'm making a mess, as I usually am. So a sponge tip actually works very, very well for this shade. And I don't have to spray it because I'm lazy. Okay, let's also use the sponge tip for the flakes then, because I have it. Let's see what it does then. Okay, so it does work. I do prefer to spray my brush though for flakes, just because of the nature of the flakes. Okay, let me finish everything off, clean everything up a little bit, and then I will be right back, show you the final look and give you my opinion on this palette. I finished off the look with Falsies in the Style Jean from AOA Studios. Lippy is a Colourpop BFF liner, the shade BFF. And then the Unique Beauty Lippy in Void, which is a black gloss. So on top of... well, basically that cooler or that brown liner, it gives me very deep dark brown glossy lip, which I really, really like. So yeah, and here is how the look came together. I really, really like it. I feel nice and Halloween-y. Yes. Oh, let me go up. Eek. And let me tell you about this palette. First off, the outside truly reflects the inside. You can really see that basically I did. If you see this and then you see my eye look, it is very much vibing, isn't it? Now, what I kind of failed to grasp was that this is a pastel palette. This is the darkest shade in the palette, and I have it true to pan, but still, it is a grungy, pastel-y palette. You know what this gives me? This gives me Corpse Bride vibes. That whole... bluey, death kind of pastel-y, Tim Burton-y look. That's what this is giving me. So it is a grungy, gothic pastel palette with some bomb-ass shimmers in there. This shade, it is so, so stunning. It is a... When I look at the mirror just below the camera, it has basically a blue-purple base, or a bluer base, and then some purpley flakes or sparkles in them, but there are also other sparkles in there. It's almost a combination between these three, and then in a shimmer form. It's very, very pretty. I feel that it is prettier when it's not sprayed, though, because I feel that sometimes when you spray, especially a shimmer shade, you kind of pack all the particles together a little bit more, which usually is what I want. That's why I sprayed. But in this case, I felt like it needed a little bit more air to breathe for all the sparkly bits to come out, if that makes any sense. And then the shade Grim Reaper. Yeah, I love a shade like this. And this is a very deep, dark steel gray, which has a hint of a purple. Am I saying that correctly? Yeah, of a purple blueness in there. So I think that it complements it very, very well. When I look in the viewfinder, I can almost see it has a little bit of a greenish, bluey, I don't know. But I really, really like the shade. And I think that the formula is very, very nice. And then we have the shade Doulahan. Yeah. She does these types of shade so, so well. And this truly is what makes the palette even more extra, because what can you do? You can use it on its own, as I did in the inner portion of my eye. You can use it as a topper, and you can use it to top off all the other shades that you're doing, but you can also create matte looks with this and then just spruce it up with this to dust that over the lid. The only thing I have to say, though, is that usually flake shades like this, I like to go in the shade with a brush that is already sprayed, so with a damp brush, because then the flakes grab the brush very well and you can still smear it on the eyeballs. So yeah, I think I feel fierce in this look. So fierce, I'm going to film another video with this look, which is going to be the Halloween special of the new makeup releases, which should go online tomorrow. So yes, but yeah, I really, really like it. The only thing, though, is I think this is a very cool gothic-y, Halloween-y pastel palette. Well, I kind of thought about the chinchilla from... I can grab it. The chinchilla from Sigil. But the chinchilla from Sigil is even more deathly. Oh no, don't dig the palette in the shade, really. So here they are side by side. So basically this shade is a little bit like this shade, but then more in a flake. So you can kind of get a similar vibe, even though this is even cooler than this one. But I know that this one currently is not sold, if I'm not mistaken. So maybe then this one can be your, can be an alternative for you. They're not the same. And as I said, this one is cooler. But yeah, this is kind of the same thing that I can get with the chinchilla palette. And maybe that is helpful. And then let's also go to this one, the Grimoire shade that I also used. Yeah, I think it's stunning. I do want to use it more. It's almost a shame to use it because the embossing is so pretty. But yeah, also, yeah, a green, a yellow, a red. And I, fun thing, I actually think it does kind of give a little bit of something extra to the look there. This was it for the Dark Souls palette. Let me know your thoughts on this one. Then we're going to go to the last one, which is Tis the Season. And that one is coming up now. Okay. The last palette is called Tis the Season. And same setup as the other ones. Although this one has four mattes and two shimmers. The shade Nautilus is a blue... Yeah, blue shimmer. It is a little bit sticky as well. And then the shade North Pole. It looks very white, but it has an icy blue shift. I thought actually that when I saw the palette at first that the shade Slay was more along the lines of a dark blue, but it's a very deep green. So yeah, I have already primed my eyes. I am going to start with the shade... Let's start with the shade Santa's Cookie. Let's just, I don't know, set the base. This is in the Halloweeny palette, the Dark Souls palette, it was a white. And this is more, for me, it's almost a flesh tone. These types of colors I usually use as an eraser shade. However, if you are deeper than me, you can use this as a pastel, if you want to. Okay, let's go next to the shade. So I'm going to go next to the shade Slay with a fluffy brush. I'm just going to, oh wow, I did not see that coming. Tapped it on my eye. Wow, it's a little bit more pigmented than I thought it would be, especially after the last palette, because that was more of a pastel. This is not. Okay. And it blends very well. I do have to say that I have already sat there though, so there's that. If it is a little bit patchy on my eye, my eyes are not really liking me right now, so they feel a little bit dry, drier than they normally would. So just that you are aware that it can create a little bit of patchiness. Okay, I'm going to go to the shade Rudolph. And it will pull a little bit more yellowy on me. So basically it will pull a little bit more towards a neutral red, because the red is a little bit more blue based, but because of the base that I have underneath and the way that it kind of turns a little bit peachy on me, it will kind of stay a little bit more red, if that makes sense. Instead of cleaning the brush, blending out the edges. Okay, then I'm going to flip the shades. I am getting a brush that's clean-ish, on blend. I'm just going to pull this in a little bit as well. Yes, cleaning it and doing the same on the other eye. Then I am going to go to the shade Down the Chimney. I'm going to deepen up both eyes. I'm basically using that line that I just made as a guide. Then I'm going to grab a blending brush. And I'm just going to finesse everything. Make sure that the blends are nice. I cleaned up a little bit underneath my brow because the green was going up a little bit too high. But it happens sometimes. Okay, I'm going to go to the shade Slay. Very, very lightly, the green. Just going to put a little bit back. I'm also going to deepen up the red side with Down the Chimney. A little bit more. I'm going to blend it basically. That's it. Going to blend it up a bit into the red. Okay, what I do want to do is a little bit of brown in the outer corner of both eyes. Just a little. And then I'm cleaning the brush. And then I'm going to blend it so that it is a little bit more cohesive. Yeah. Let's go to the shimmers. I'm going to go to the blue called Naughty List. And this is like the... what was the shade? The purple shade Necromancer in the Dark Souls palette. This one also has kind of a shimmery in it. Now there is a reason that I'm using it dry right now. And that reason is, it's just not my favorite color. But I still want to try it, you know? I think this is one that will work best with your finger. Or a sponge tip. Now I have a sponge tip, so let's try it. Apparently we're going for a very dark Christmas. Then, because I have the sponge tip anyway, I'm going to go to the shade North Pole. Oh, now that is nice. I think it's an apt name. Okay, okay. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to smear the shade North Pole on my entire lid. I'm going to brush it over, so I'm using it dry now. Okay, let's spray it just for funsies because we can. It makes that light blue even more pronounced. I think that if you put it on top of the green, it will pull a little bit more green. Which is very, very fun to play with. Okay. Yeah, it pulls a little bit more green. I think it will make the red a little bit more purple, but it doesn't matter. Funky! Let me finish everything off. Choose eye pencils, falsies, a lippy, and the works, and then I will give you my opinion on this palette. I finished off the look with two eye pencils, a red one and a green one. The red one is... Oh, I think it broke. Oh no. It's actually a lip pencil from Catrice that I use as an eye pencil. And then the green one is from Kiko. It's in the style... It's a foresty, kind of a foresty green. They will be listed down below. Lippy is a plumping lip liner from Catrice, a red one. And then also the red gloss from Unique Beauty in the shade Ruby. Falsies are Style Jean from AOA Studios. Now, I have to say that this is not my best work. Honestly, it's not my best work. My eyes are kind of done, though. With all the filming that I have done, doesn't matter. I feel that in this, falsies save the day. Now that everything is done, though, I'm kind of getting Sally from Nightmare Before Christmas vibes. So, there is that. Let me chat about the palette though. When I look at the outside, again, it really reflects the shades that are on the inside. And I think that if we're just going to go to the mattes, I think that it is a very Christmassy theme. Now the shade Santa's Cookie, for me, it could have been any other shade. Because it's not a shade that I use personally, but I know that a lot of people do like it. And I do like it to set the base because the other shades, especially the green and the brown, are very dark and a little bit more on the cooler side. And that is why I like to set my eyeshadow base before I go in with shades like this, especially where I'm going to blend, basically like I did today. And yeah, then let's go to the two shimmers. Now, if you know me a little bit longer, you know that this is not really my favorite color. And it's still not really my favorite color. I do like it in combination with this shade though. So the way that I have used it today, I think is really, really pretty. But for me, this could have been any other shade. It's just personal preference. I don't use blues like this often. It's usually not the color that I go for. Quality wise though, I think it is a very, very nice palette. These two shades felt a little bit drier when I swatched them, but they worked perfectly. I really like the quality on this. I think that in the collection, it certainly has its place. Honestly, it is my least favorite of the three. Not gonna lie. Just because of the way that the color story is set up, it makes me... I have to think a little bit differently on how I want to build up my looks. Now, if you break the palette down into different colors, so basically do more looks with this palette, then it is very, very pretty.